We have allowed the devil to trample down the strength of the Lord in our lives by the darkness we have invited for ourselves. If you are still eating from the trash can and dustbin, it's your fault. Clean yourself and that dustbin will disappear. Sanctify your life, change your garments, and the curse of that spirit will leave you alone. Continue your crooked ways and your conny, you think say you are wise. Your rags will follow you. I can hear the cry of many people. Even the dead are crying because there are people who are dying because of this hunger. In their grave, they are crying. And truly, I can hear the cries of the living and the dead. I hear spirits crying. And some stupid people say that, well, it is universal, so we should go to sleep. Who told us that we are supposed to be in this? Is the oil not still flowing? Is gold not still being dug in Niger State and all the other states? Is the mining not still going on, illegal mining and legal ones? Are people not buying? Why are we in this situation? The economy is still working, but it's not profiting the inhabitants. Have you not read in the Bible that when in the midst of plenty you are hungry, that it is a curse? I repeat, in the midst of plenty, go and look at it. It's one of the curses in the Bible. You have plenty. It's a curse. It means it's a spiritual what? Problem. The Bible says in that verse 12, if I read the whole man Bible, it says, because of rebellion, a host together with the daily sacrifice will be given over. This is last year. I said, your blood will not be on my head. I remember saying that. When that time comes, your blood will not be on my head. I have done what a pastor and a teacher should do. What a leader should do. What a prophet should do. Prepare the people. The Bible says in verse 12, in the second part, according to the whole man Bible, the horn will throw truth to the ground and will be successful in whatever it does. When you throw truth to the ground, what does that mean? It means by wickedness, the horn will be rolling. Is that not what we have in Nigeria now? Is that not what we have in some, not all, other nations in Africa, other nations in Europe? People are standing truth in the head and making a lie the standard, and wickedness. People have become heartless. They like pretending that they are sympathizing with you, but they are still stealing more and more and more. Are you sympathizing with me and still stealing the only source of life I have? But the Bible here says it is a spiritual problem. That if you will cast away your own filthy garments, and light begins to grow. This darkness will be swallowed. He said, then I heard a holy one speaking, and another holy one, the other one said, the saint, said to the speaker, how long will the events of this vision last? The daily sacrifice, The rebellion that makes desolate. It's a rebellion. Even those ruling us that are doing the evil things, it's a rebellion against God. It's not just referring to your own rebellion, it's referring to the rebellion of government. The rebellion that makes desolate the giving over of the sanctuary and of the host to be trampled on. Hell has taken over the altar. I was watching churches that were holiness churches. Recently, I've been seeing some samples in the social media. Maybe those are exaggerated. But churches that were holiness churches, when they dance for you these days, you will wonder what is the difference. Then those who are not holiness movement, they have gotten worse. When they dance, you see Satan directly. That is why during the preaching, they sleep throughout. They so overdanced. It is in that dance they get into the spirit and prophesy a lie. Not from a sober spirit. The Bible here says the daily sacrifice, the pure sacrifice the church used to give, plus the rebellion that makes desolate, the giving over of the sanctuary. The sanctuary can only be given over by the owners of the sanctuary. If I don't let Satan inside here. You know, I saw one this evening, one of those social media stuff. This time it was CAC. I think they saw everybody talking about their churches. So they too started, they dramatized it. They wanted to push that dark. You can see that they are struggling to push that darkness away. And most of them women, they came out, they said, look, we are Bible-believing Christians. The next person came out, we don't believe in wearing trousers. On social media. So if you are wearing trousers, don't go to CAC. Did you hear what I just said? They are making it clear. They are drawing their line by force. Since everybody is imposing a demon cloud, let them remove that cloud and put the identity of their church there. Those who wear trousers, don't enter our church. Go and remove it at home. Put on your nice wrapper or your skirt. Look beautiful and come back to church. They are not ashamed to tell that the skirt must be long. I've not seen any church proclaim that publicly recently. Just like in the 70s. Now, that gave me hope today. They came out. We believe in casting out demons and we speak in tongues. We believe in prophecy. We prophesy in our church. And by prophetic utterance, we bring deliverance to people. Wow. And they were saying it one by one. Their doctrinal beliefs. Putting it on the doorpost. You have to put your holiness on the doorpost. That is why the Jews wear the word on their forehead. They put a scroll on their head. They wrap it. It's the word of God. That is the light that shows them the path through life. It's always on their forehead. When I saw that today, others introduce themselves and they end up with their dancing and they start showing their bum bum. Is that part of your doctrinal belief? They start with it, they end with it. No wonder there are so many demons in that church. We have invited the devil to our churches. And we are afraid to take a stand. Today, this year, I cast down that spirit from the church. I invite the Lord to enter into his church and begin to scatter and purge every church that is not living according to the word. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Amen. I didn't hear somebody say, my God, arise. And let your enemies be scattered. Now, I saw something before I read this. And what I saw was that the demonic world had taken so much taken over the earth, that it has weakened righteousness. And it has so weakened righteousness that the solution to the problems of the nation is slow in coming. And it was like we needed to clean up the pipe through which the solution must go through. And the pipe is the church. Somebody was challenging the EFCC chairman. Of course, everybody knows he's a pastor. But the zeal with which he has entered into this his work is frightening some people. I said, come. Is it, somebody asked, had to ask somewhere, is it not when the government is righteous that you can succeed in this your zeal? He said, from the beginning you are going to fail. And I sat quietly and I meditated on those words. If the one who sent you is not righteous, how can you succeed in establishing a kingdom of righteousness? We're talking about the potentate God, the final solution. Can you stand up on your feet? Can you tell the Lord, any spirit that is stealing from me and stealing from Nigeria, find them in their darkness and cut them off. Tonight we are entering into covenant. Set me free from my own shadows and set me free from the shadows of this nation. Now listen, before you pray, that 12 says, because of rebellion, a host, referring to spirits, angels, together with the daily sacrifice, all the sacrifices made to change the situation. We'll be given over. That means we'll be defeated. It means the Bible is saying that there are powers and principalities that have brought us to where we are today. Can you tell the Lord today, we renounce the power of those powers. And today we are asking that you overthrow them over Nigeria and their government. Can you tell the Lord, every power that has overshadowed and overtaken Nigeria, today I renounce their power and I take away the power from them. And I ask that you rebuke them in this night vigil and begin to push them out and open the gates for Nigeria to prosper. We're saying that this year God is going to break doors or open some doors. Now, I'm asking you to break doors. And I'm asking you to open the gates. Break every door where they have tied us. Every witchcraft anybody has done to tie down this nation. Father, we break it. Open your mouth and begin to pray. And that wherever your own portion is included, can you come against that spirit and release that spirit, and release your portion from that prison gate. Can you put Psalms 85 verse 9 on the screen? Open your eyes and let's read Psalms 85 verse 9. Surely his salvation is nigh them that fear him. That is what he says. Put the King James Version, please. He says, surely his salvation is near them that what? What did he say? Is there hope for you? Why? His salvation is near those that fear him. That glory may dwell where? Did he say in our lives? No, it said where? Land. Is Nigeria our land? That glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Can somebody say amen to that?
Amen.
Then what will happen when these kiss themselves and they marry themselves? What will happen? Truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from where? Heaven. Yea, the Lord shall give that which is good, and our land shall yield what? It is because of this oppression that our land is not yielding her. But the Bible says the Lord will give that which is good, and our land. Every business that is oppressed, we break the yoke of that business tonight. That's why today, whether you are selling Ororo in the market, or you are selling tires, or you are a carpenter, or you are a forwarder and backwarder, importer and exporter, whatever kind of business you are doing, if you are doing any kind of business, step out of to this front. Just come to the front. Just come to the front. I don't care what kind of business you are doing. La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la la la la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la
We want to dwell.
Come, I don't know you to be a businessman. Stay here. Only those who are business people.
Low like a mighty wind. Spirit of victory. Come out of sweet your wind. Blow like a mighty wind. Spirit of victory. Cover us with your wing. We want to see you like a mighty rushing wind. We want to dwell under the shadow of your wings. Oh, we want to see you like a mighty rushing wind. We want to dwell under the
this nation. And that is affecting our lives. We agree together that you separate our portion from the portion of the cursed. From the portion of the curse. From the portion of the curse. Separate my portion now. In the name of Jesus, I ask that you water my ground and affect my destiny and rebuke the devourer in the name of Jesus. Set my portion free from their oppressions, the oppression of the horn of the wicked ones in the name of Jesus. I invite the blood of Jesus to break the yoke now. Break the yoke now. Break the yoke now. Break the yoke now. Can you say, where there is inflation, let my blessing come double, far above the inflation. In the name of Jesus, I hold you for your word that in this season you will make me a king. I am a king by the sacrifice of the blood of Jesus. And today I lay hold on that authority to destroy these powers of oppression and to break it in my waters and to break it in my waters and break my business loose against them in Jesus' name. Can you wave to the Lord and shout amen? Can you wave to the Lord and shout amen? Can you wave to the Lord and shout amen? Now listen, I want to repeat this again. The Lord told me that what is happening in this nation is spiritual and physical. It's spiritual. And the spiritual has found sons of darkness to lead the war against the destiny of this nation. Can you ask the Lord to take his word? His sword, wherever they are, let him begin to cut them down. These sons of darkness that are leading this thing, the destruction of the nations of the earth, let the Lord take his sword and begin to cut them down. The same way he cut down Nebuchadnezzar in the day of his pride. Let a cleansing begin. Tell the Lord, as he cuts them down, let him make a highway for the nation. Let the door of redemption open. Let the door of redemption open. Ya Allah. Kaya bunda kakeso nabakaraina kaya bunda kakeso mencheto kaya bunda kakeso nabakaraina kaya bunda kakeso maiko kaya bunda kakeso Abakaraina, Kayabude Kakeso, my Girma, Kayabude Kakeso, Abakaraina, Kayabude Kakeso. That Psalms 85, verse 9 says, put it on the screen for them to see. Surely his salvation is near them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Can you tell the Lord, I welcome your salvation to my life and my dwelling and to my business. I open the gates of my business for the help that your salvation brings. For the help that your salvation brings. For the prosperity that your salvation brings. For the glory that your salvation brings. And I thank you for hearing me. I thank you for hearing me. In Jesus' name. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Verse 11 says, truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. I hope those who are controlling these things are putting it on the screens for them to see. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. Can you say, Lord, let righteousness, can you ask the Lord that righteousness should take over our heavens? Should take over our heavens. That righteousness should spring out now from our earth, from the land under my feet, from my nation. I call forth righteousness in the name of Jesus. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Yeah, the Bible says in verse 12, yea, the Lord shall give that which is good, and our land shall yield her increase. Can you say, I receive increase from my own land? So let my land give that which is good, according to the blessing of the Lord tonight. Let the word of the Lord fertilize the land under my feet and break the yoke of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Lastly, let's read verse 13 together, everybody. Righteousness, everybody now, shall we read it? Righteousness shall go before me and set us in the way of his. Now, listen. The Bible says there is a place where wealth, where gold is found. Now, the Bible won't say that if God does not know the place. And so now, you remember the Hausa adage? Kafanka, kafana. Go. Can you raise your right leg and say, Gakafana? Dagayo. That's how you are speaking Hausa by force now, eh? Dagayo. Kafanka. Kafana. Al kawali de naide kafana kena. Tsakanina de kai. Ya ubangijina. A chicken sunan yesu. But you want to hear, I mean, but. I made everyone now just made a covenant. I made everyone make a covenant. That Lord, and you lifted your leg. According to Psalms 85, verse 13. And you said, Lord, there is a Hausa adage that says, eh? I want a house on the eye. Not just like with a trenchy. You see, look at this bush people. They want to interpret it in English, and they are just doing direct translation. Your leg, my leg. That means whatever step you take, my leg, it goes with you, enters there with you. So today, I enter into covenant with my leg that wherever your leg steps, my leg steps there as well. Did you hear what I said? Now, I'm using this to let you understand the meaning of verse 12. Shall we all read verse 12 together? Because it's a powerful covenant that is going to take you to the place of your wealth from here. And that's why I ask you to come out. It's a very powerful scripture. Righteousness shall go before him and shall do what? Set us. Set us. That means you are not the one who will be setting up yourself. Eh? His righteousness will go before you and he will set you up. He said he will set us in the way of his steps. The steps of the Lord will lead you into trouble. Amen. The steps of the Lord will lead you into poverty.
Amen.
So if there is poverty where you are now, I change your environment in Jesus' name. As you step out of this place tonight, your legs will carry you to the place of glory. You will not go back to the place of the worries that you are coming from. Can you say, I receive in the name of Jesus? I didn't hear somebody say amen to that. He said they will carry your legs in his steps. In his steps. That's why I quoted that the Bible says there is a way where gold is found in the book of Proverbs. There is a way where silver is found. There is a way where prosperity is found. And here he says he will send righteousness before you to drive away the darkness. And then he will make your leg take steps along with his legs. That means his legs will become the teacher of your legs today. Can you say, Father, I say amen to this. So can you go ahead and just give God thanks and tell him that let him carry your legs now to the place where the secret of your blessing is in this 2024. Let your leg not miss it. That is a covenant of this night vigil. Carry my legs to the place where the secret is for this 2024. In Jesus' name. Now, I don't know how to do this. Can you just take this oil? Where are my zonal pastors? Come up. Actually, I didn't know you were a full-time businessman like that. And you are here to buy me a car. Because I know you must prosper plenty before you can buy me a car. Be careful. Don't match what you should not match. Don't cross holy things. That is what your holiness should be teaching you by now. You will take that oil. I know it's not our money, so just forget about what I just said. Just don't be caught, that's all. You will take this oil. You anoint your own hands first. When you go to your seat, you can remove your socks and anoint your feet. Now, they will just drop the oil on your hands. You go to your seat, anoint your feet. The feet that you made that covenant with. And let that last verse come to your mind. And repeat it again before the Lord. Kafanka. So you are tying the Lord by covenant to his word. Father, I release the life of the Holy Spirit into these oils. And I ask that you unlock its gates according to your word. And let your life by your word carry your children from this place. And show your glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Can you begin to anoint your hands? As you anoint your hands, can you spread? Please spread. Don't stay in one place. Let me not teach you how to do your work. Pour the oil on these people.
Of your spirit, carry me, Jesus, carry me.
Rub the tin on your hands and then spread the tin to them.
Carry me.
If you are not carrying any oil, go back to your seat.
The wings of your spirit, carry me, Jesus, carry me. Jesus.
Watu zaki shafa ahano maiden baya kin karban maiden hanu ki shafa hanunki ubangije barkace hanunki amfanin hanunki ki doka hanunki shafa kafanki ki alkawali da ubangije akan wannan aya da muka karanta cewa daga yau kafan shi kafanka ku zama da ya tare kenan ko ba haka ba in case ba yi muku fasarin da kyau ba ba fasarta muku da kyau ba abinda na fada ayi kenan so in ka karban maidin ku kokin karban maidin zaki shafa a hannu ubangiji ya sa albarka ga aikin hannunki amma banda wannan ki shiga alkawali da ubangiji cewa daga yau ga kafafuwana ki shafa kafanki a can ki ce kafanka kafana ka bi kalmar magananka bari wani ya ce amen apostle go welcome I was going to welcome you from the beginning, but my head was more in what was happening in the spirit that I forgot the physical for a moment until I stood by you and your anointing hit me. Then I remembered that you are there. Sometimes I need to be woken up. He's the PFN chairman for Kaduna State, and I want to welcome all other PFN leaders and CAN leaders that are present, CAN leaders that are present here today. The new executive came to greet me in the office last week, I think. And I was so glad that they had a smooth transition and that the Holy Ghost chose for us Christian leaders that are fearless and will take us to the next level. Our prayers are with you. We just want to let you know. Listen, I'm going to give you an assignment. And that is step number two for tonight. I'm taking it step by step. Before we close tonight, that is why we come. It's a wind of the Spirit. And the Lord just shows us areas to touch. We touch them. And we close. How many of you can feel that the Lord has taken over? Those of you who apply the oil. Can you just bless the Lord? Now, can you, that hand you used to bless the Lord, just put it by your nostrils and breathe in the scent of the oil. Let it enter into your breath and push you from today. From today, the Lord has made you a fruitful vine. I say the Lord has made you a fruitful vine. You will go and take over. No wind, no iska will steal from you from today. Amen. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Amen. So start breaking into the promises of God for this year. Because I had the Lord say, immediately you do that, an acceleration will take over. And today, I release you as an accelerated one. Amen. Just this evening, as I prayed, God reminded me that each of us is supposed to be a smeared one. That is why, again, I gave you the oil. So that by the smearing of the oil, smearing, the name Christ means anointed one. Messiah means anointed one. All of them mean anointed one. And I just heard the Lord saying he was going to smear people, so that they can connect with the spirit realm against the other realm that is at war in this season. But the second assignment he said I should give you, and I want you to note it. Ezekiel chapter 20 verse 46. What does it say? Ezekiel 20. 46. Can't see my second phone. Okay. Just when I needed the screen, my own screen is not working. Son of man, set thy face towards the south. Everybody, shall we read? Wait. He says, and drop what? Is he telling God to drop his word? Who is he telling to drop his word? You, the Son of Man. Now, when God calls you Son of Man, it means spirit man. Spirit man. It's not referring to your flesh. The Son is capital S. Thou that art transformed by the Lord, anointed one. Anointed one. It's not you just commanding the winds anyhow. He's talking to the spirit man in you, the Christian in you, the born again person in you. Now, look at what that scripture says. It says, Son of man, set thy face towards where? And do what? Drop. Somebody say, drop. Can you say, from today I'll begin to drop something? Drop, because I'm coming there now. I'm taking you to that next way. He said, drop thy word towards where? The south. And prophesy against the forest of the south field. The forest. South has a, you think they don't have forest? They have fields. They have trees everywhere. The oils, even the trees grow from the water there. In the south. You can enter into some swamps, which is a mixture of potopoto and water. And you will get lost inside that swamp. It's a forest of swamp in the south. And in the days when their enemies attack them, they use those places to hide. You can't find them. If you enter there, the swamp will swallow you. It only knows its owners. Listen, because this is very important. God is saying, spirit son, spirit man, face, set thy face towards the south. Drop thy word towards the south and prophesy against the forest of the south. Whatever juju the forest of the south has used to swallow the wealth of the south, let it release it. Now, I'm giving you the prayer item. Whatever sorcery, whatever iniquity, sin, by which the glory of the forest of the south has been swallowed or taken away by strangers, they that dwell in the land don't profit from it. Oh yeah, let that juju break. But you must drop your word breaking that juju. Son of man. If you don't drop your word, that juju will continue to rule that south. That means the spirits that oppress the south, you know, we started from spirits. We said spirits have brought darkness to the land. So I'm still continuing. The spirits that oppress most of the south come from their forest places. There is no part of the south that does not have forest. Did you hear what I said? Now, how do I know? Particularly the south of Nigeria. How do I know? That is why the Fulanis are all over Nigeria. They don't live in the cities. They live where? In the bush, in the forest. Forest spirits. Forest spirits in the south. He said, drop your word. I saw that very clearly, that my head was in a swoon this evening with the Lord. And I said, Lord, I pray you will get through people who carry out this. So all of you who came from the south, once you step into the south tomorrow, begin to drop your word. Command the southern spirits to let go their captivity.
command the spell by which it is shut down to let go the wealth of the land and the people of the land. Command a new spirit to war against those spirits. Let them not give them rest until they are cut off. Did I hear somebody say amen? That means release the word of God to control the powers there. I repeat, release God's written word to do what? Through the spoken. The Bible says when it leaves your mouth, it shall not return back to you void, because you are a spirit man. Release the word of God to rule, to set boundaries. I think in one of my teachings, or one of the teachings last year or this year, we talked about setting boundaries, releasing the word to set boundaries. And God seems to be repeating that over and over again. To bring limitation to the wicked spirit, to the wicked messenger. Limit them by my word. You shall not reign anymore. By my word, you will not prosper. By my word. Elijah was a specialist in dropping the word. By my word, there shall be no rain. By my word. The others will say, if I be the servant of God, this will drop the word. That is how you drop the word. Drop the word. God says the month of March will be used in dropping the word. Somebody said, drop the word. Drop the word. Drop the word. Drop the word. The month of March will be used in dropping bombs over Nigeria. The word. The word. The word. The word. And when you drop the word, you will prophesy that God should create a new thing. A new thing. Ezekiel 21 verse 2 is the second scripture. Put it on the screen. Ezekiel 21 verse 2. Everybody, shall we repeat it together again? What does it say? Son of man, towards Jerusalem, and do what? Towards the holy places and prophesy. Now, listen. You will do this in two paths. The word says, drop the word against Jerusalem because it is the capital of the great king. Against every spirit that is at war in Jerusalem. So each time you are dropping the word in the south or in the north where you are for your territory to be controlled, drop the word for Jerusalem. But the reason why they were dropping the word in Jerusalem was because it was the capital and it was a city of the great king. Now, listen, because very important. Jerusalem is controlled by holy places. That's why the Muslims and the Christians are fighting. It's over the holy places that are there. The two religions, those two places are their most holy places. Three religions, Christians, Jews and Muslims. For Muslims, outside Medina, the next most important place, and they don't know which one is more important, is that holy mountain. Where they believe that Adam was created. Is that holy mountain where they believed that Abraham sacrificed his son, went to sacrifice his son. Is that same holy mountain, Mount Moreb, that same holy mountain where the temples stood It's a holy hill. And they both believe it's the same place. But there is a fourth prayer item there. It means drop your word against all the holy places that control your nation. That is the fourth prayer item. Drop a word against every so-called holy place in quote, that control the nation. Whether in an evil matter or in a good way, drop your word. Somebody say, drop your word. So there are four prayer items in that, or three. One is the capital, the city of the great king itself. Drop your word on it. And I said the same way, drop that word on the capital of your nation, Nigeria. If I didn't say so, I have said that now. Drop it on Abuja. That which you have dropped in the south and in the north, wherever you come from, in the east or in the west, drop it also over the capital. Prophesy towards the capital and all the high places that control it, that influence it, that pray over it, that the Lord will begin to interfere with strange prayers. Any strange prayer against Nigeria that should not be, let the Lord cut it down. Any prayer that will help fulfill prophecy, whether negative or good, let the Lord promote it. Now, do you understand what I'm saying? Drop your word. Somebody said, drop your word. God needs to hear your own voice over the affairs of your nation. I don't care from which nation you come from. I don't care from which church you come from. I don't care about the beliefs of your church. As long as you pray for the good of this nation, you must take a specific word from the Bible and drop it. Are we making sense tonight? When we start dropping that word everywhere, we will start breaking the spell. I repeat, we will start breaking the spell. The spell will start loosening. The hold on Nigeria will start getting weaker. That's why I read that Daniel scripture. For that horn to be able to even control the Christian powers from the altar tells you it must be very powerful. It must be the horn of Lucifer himself. But God is saying, drop your word. Drop your word. Drop your word. And as you are dropping, you are breaking the spell. You are breaking the spell. You are breaking the spell. Turn to your neighbor and say, drop your word. How many of you promise to do something about this? Whether you know how to pray or you don't know how to pray, it doesn't matter. Just find a scripture. Release it and say, God, let this scripture not rest until it has been fulfilled. And give it specific address. Asovila, this is what the word of the Lord says. Father, I'm a simple person. I am a farmer. Like they will say in the Bible. The other one will say, I'm a shepherd. I look after cattle. But then you called me to prophesy from my cattle. So I am dropping the word. Your word says this. Let it rest and over Nigeria. Let it not return to be empty. Let it not return until it has finished its purpose. In Jesus' name I pray. And then by yourself you will shout, Amen. It's settled. Says, drop your word, prophesy. Prophesy. And when you prophesy, you can also include some of the scriptures you have read. That you have read tonight. I'm going to do something in a moment. We're going to do something in a moment. An
and then we'll start to round up for tonight. Deuteronomy 32 verse 2. You see, part of the problem we are facing now, and Jeremiah 23:29, part of the problems we are facing now is that our word mean nothing. When you drop it, nothing happens, because you have not consecrated yourself for that word. So when you leave here, start a process of consecration. You say, Lord, let my word no longer mean nothing. Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 2. My doctrine shall drop as the rain. And my speech shall distill as the dew. Can you say tonight, my word must mean something? Because when you spoke it before, it didn't mean anything to anybody. It didn't mean anything to spirits. It didn't mean anything. It didn't do anything for any human being. So nobody did fear you. But the day it starts doing something, people will be what? Afraid of you. Now, look at who was speaking. Moses. If you look at verse 1, what does it say? Give ye ear, O ye heavens, and I will speak. And what does it say? Hear, O earth, the words of my mouth. That means the earth has always reacted to what? The words of his mouth. Has the earth been reacting to the word of your mouth? If it has not, you have a problem. Something is wrong with you. Definitely wrong with your Christianity. Definitely wrong with your consecration. I repeat, it's consecration that makes the word effective. If there is no consecration in your life, or your life is not concentrated, your word cannot be effective. Start living a life of consecration. Sanctification. Start hallowing the word, that the word might hallow you. Don't live double standard. You speak one word, but you are doing another thing, and you don't feel it. If you don't feel it, that is why your word is meaningless when you speak it. It is from the place of consecration that the word of your mouth gets its power. Give ear, O ye heavens, and I will speak. Oh yeah, I'm about to speak. Heaven, open up and answer me. That is what he's saying. And hear, O earth, the words of my mouth. Then he goes on to say in verse 2, my doctrine, whatever I believe in, shall drop as what? The rain. And my speech shall distill as the dew. How many of you know the meaning of the word distill? It means purify. It means soak in. When something soaks in and softens you and empowers you. That means each time Moses spoke, something break. Something was softened. The word had a life in it. It says, as the small rain upon the tender herb. Let me tell you, that rain upon the tender herb is the one that activates the herb to heal. That same distilled dew upon a tender herb makes the herb to heal. It activates the herb to heal. It activates the herb to multiply. It activates the herb to grow. And as the showers upon the... What does the shower do to the grass? It makes it green. It makes it grow. Is your word useless? It's because you don't have a consecration. I hear the Lord calling the church back to consecration. And that is why, if you are a throne room ordained pastor or a throne room preacher, or you are a pastor, even if you are not from throne room, I want you to leave your seat and come forward. If you are a preacher, you are a pastor, our word must no longer mean nothing. I repeat, when you come forward, tell God that today, my word must cease to mean nothing. Today, in the name of Jesus, I have come to ask for power and life, a restoration of my signs, the signs that follow the word. If you were ordained in throne room to serve, whether as a priest, a preacher, or a pastor, I want you to begin to ask the Lord. Tell him that today you have come for an open consecration. You want to be reconsecrated. Let the Lord change your garment and make your word meaningful. This second month, I'm hearing the Lord saying, set things in order so that the year can be fruitful. This is the problem of the church, consecration. Many of us have left our holiness. Our flesh is not clean. Our spirits and our hearts are not clean. Our thoughts are not clean. Your works are not clean. Tell God to shift things and break that wall. Let the spirit of a new consecration come upon you. Let the Lord wash you with the blood. Nimaimba ku utawa injishima so. I don't want to struggle for miracles. I want God to give me rest from that kind of struggle. I had the Lord say things tonight. I'm not going to say yet, because that is coming for the last phase. Kunzogreni dukanku ku masunawimbaya. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Now, open your eyes and look at me. Consecration attracts God to occupy every bit of your body that is left. The more you are consecrated, the more God possesses the portions of your body, your spirit, your soul, and the realms around you. He only dwells in those that have clean hands and a clean heart or a clean spirit. Consecration allows him come physically, takes over your space and makes it his space, and then challenges what makes your spirit bitter.
challenges your circumstances from your space, not from heaven. But it's consecration that brings him down. Are you consecrated? If you are not, you better go and learn consecration. I heard God say these basic things must be settled tonight. The reason why your signs are not strong is that you're not consecrated either spiritually or in your own soul or in your own heart. There is no consecration. Like when deeper life first started, before they found the right words for all of these things, they spoke about holiness of the heart. And by holiness, they mean purity of the heart. Because holiness is just a very ambiguous word. The specific is the purity of your heart. Listen. You need to The Bible says, draw nigh unto me and I will draw nigh unto you. Consecration brings you very close to him. And say, Lord, it's like saying, Lord, I give you the body to use. I give you the spirit to use. I clean it up for you. My heart will not do anything evil that you don't want done. And even when there is a conflict, I choose you rather than my flesh. Because there will always be conflict. Like Paul will say, your flesh wants one thing. Your spirit is referring to another thing. And he said, who shall deliver me from this flesh of sin? Thanks be to God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Can you bow your head and tell the Lord to drop the things you need to drop out of your life? Tell the Lord to drop the things now, the weights, whether they are spiritual, physical, whether they are iniquities or lust or greed or a lying spirit. Many of us are carrying weights. A jealous spirit, the wrong kind of jealousy. An angry spirit, always angry for nothing. Tell the Lord to drop those weights. Drop these weights out of me. And create a new spirit within me. Make me worthy to carry you. Make me worthy to represent you. Restore the power of my mouth. Let the words of my mouth be able to distill from now. Bring my consecration to the place where my words will mean something to the earth and mean something to the heavens and mean something to my fellow human beings. Let it be a cutting edge, a sharp knife that can cut through the spirit, soul, bones and marrows of people and bring healing, restoration and salvation. That's what that scripture means in Deuteronomy 32. Can you please put your hand on your head? Tell the Lord to take you from this earth to where he is, to his dwelling place now. And change your garments there. And return you as a changed man with a divine ability. Force. That dew can heal. That dew can make grasses grow. Turn them green. That dew can make the herb effective.
Any herb that is not fully grown from the earth becomes poison. It is when it is well nourished that you get the fullness of herbs. That is why there are grains today that do not carry the healing powers they used to carry. Too much chemicals have destroyed their powers. Your granules don't look like granules again. They don't bring quality oil anymore, because the granules themselves are no longer quality. They are chemicals. Your chickens are no longer nourishing anymore. They have become killing fields, because the chickens are now chemicals. Can you tell the Lord, let your word become a distilling power that can heal and give life? I receive the gift and the blessing of this covenant. Like Moses ruled over the heavens and the earth, let me begin to rule now in Jesus' name. Open your eyes and look at me. I was listening to a sermon this evening by a rabbi. And he said in the rabbinical tradition, in every generation, every 50 years, every jubilee, the Moses spirit is replayed in chosen leaders in that generation, or chosen men. They manifest in the power. Moses operated like a god. He parted the Red Sea. He made plagues to stop, and he could call plagues, manufacture them. He killed fallen spirits, giants that had slept with the children of men and gave birth to giants. Sihon, king of Og, killed them. No wonder his character was so controversial. And sometimes his weaknesses overwhelmed him. But in spite of that, because he was the meekest of men, broken, always returning back to consecration, the heavens were under his feet. The earth was under his feet. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, let the forces of the heavens and the earth be drawn under your feet. Amen. Therefore, I rebuke your limitation tonight. Amen. And I break the curse of your yoke. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. And he said, without the Moses spirit in any generation, that generation will perish. That generation will have no direction. That generation will never connect with Canaan, the land of rest. That means that generation will never know rest. Where are the Moses of our generation to move this cloud that is upon the nations? I release them from your lives now, and I ordain them to be effective. Receive in the name of Jesus. How many of you are understanding what God is saying now? There is a cry for consecrated lives. That's why they allow you to sit. God told me actually to make you come. I wrote it here. To make you step out. He said in every generation, I became afraid. His name is Ginsburg. As I listened to him, I became afraid. Very old man. He will soon be 90. And he was talking, tired. When the Moses spirit does not exist in a generation, that generation will end in a pit. It will die. It will die an untimely death. But God has ensured that in every generation, there is a Moses reincarnation in another man. It comes from consecration, brokenness and meekness and death, everything that Moses represented. Are you that person? If you are not, that is why we are losing the battle.
So the last prayer we're going to pray is Jeremiah 23, 29, and you can go to your seat. Put it on the screen, let them see it. 23, 29. God, turning your words into fire and hammer. That was the way it was ordained. Where is it? Put it on this screen, not on my own screen there. It says, is not my word like a fire, as a fire, saith the Lord, like a hammer that breaketh. Look, everyone that has the Spirit of God, his word is supposed to be like what? Hammer that breaks. No matter how hard the ground is, your word will break it. No matter how difficult that heart is, your word will convert that heart. Can you bow your head and tell the Lord? Bring me to the place where my words is a fire. My word is a fire. And my word is a hammer that can break anything, any hard ground. Let it become like distilled waters that is found in the dew. The dew is a distilled water. That's why you can even drink the dew if you're able to gather it in a cup. It's clean water. Let it be like distilled water. That's why people drink rain water. If you took it from the open heavens, it won't hurt you. Distilled water. I need this fire in my bones. I need this fire in my mouth. I need it in my body. Lord, forgive me, but give me this fire. Break me, but give me this fire. Open me up. I sanctify myself for this fire. I enter into covenant tonight for this fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Go back to your seat. I was not going to pray for you because each of you will have to earn it for yourself. You didn't help me to get to where I am today. I stayed in the place of travail with God the Father, and he lifted me up. Each of you will have to work out your own salvation by yourself. Work out your anointing by yourself. Get it by yourself. But it only comes by deep consecration and a deep separation. Miss this, there are times I see some miracles that I wasn't expecting after I had prayed. I thought nothing would happen. And the miracles happened, and I start crying like a baby. Today, an uncommon miracle will happen to somebody here tonight. Amen. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Amen. But God is calling every preacher of the word. Every speaker of the word. To consecrate themselves to the place of Moses. In fact, it was today I was learning that one of the meanings of Moses also is the Messiah. I didn't know that aspect, but they had a way of connecting it. I was just listening. Not that I accepted it, but he operated like a Messiah. He was a sent one. Don't forget. He was fetched out of the water. Learned the ways of astrology and the Egyptian gods Baal in a palace where the king, a human being, was God. In the flesh, he identified with his people and became a castaway. because of identifying with his people. He had to run. It was in the bush he met the other God. And that God said, go save my people. Does that not make him a Messiah? His walk was that of a Messiah. He said, go save my people. Behold, today, I make you a God over Pharaoh. So he became a God. He earned the name God from God. Did you hear what I said? That's why they called him king in Jeshurun. I make you a God. He earned the name God from God over Pharaoh. Can you earn that name, God? That's why I said you must go to him and find the flow of your consecration. And then become a God. Oh, may God give you understanding for tonight. It's the winds of the Spirit, but it's coming as a hard thing. It's not noise. God is saying tonight we must put things in order so that we can win what is ahead. It's not gra-gra that will help you win it. And he really operated like God. What no man has done, he was doing. He commanded nature, it obeyed him. Who changed times and seasons at any second. It can make the earth become darkness when it is daytime. By just one word. And then he can clear the darkness into light. He can make day run into day and night run into night. Moses, because God crowned him as a God. You, what has God called you? What has he made you? Not confessional. It is in your manifestation. Your manifestation announces who you are, not your empty pride. Not looking for respect that is not from the anointing. Let people fear you from the place of anointing, from the place of your works. You don't take it by force, you don't get it by force, you don't beg it from people, you earn it. Go back to the man who gives you that and let him fill you up. How many of us will say amen to that? Amen. Thank you, Father. He has done great things. Hallelujah.
He has done great things.
Hallelujah.
He has done great things. Bless his holy name.
Hallelujah.
He has done great things.
Hallelujah.
He has done great things.
Hallelujah.
He has done great things. Bless his holy He has done great things. He has done
great things.
He has done great things.
He has done
great things.
He has done great things.
Oh, he has done great things.
Bless his holy name.
Bless his
part of tonight. Can you stand up? Can you tell the Father, cover me with your glory as I'm standing today? Let my life take a new turn. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, as it was in that great Red Sea, when you divided the sea and a cloud of fire, and fire followed them everywhere, and a cloud followed them also, and you covered them in that cloud, you covered them in that fire. Today, set for me my own building. Set up for me my own building. Cover me with something in your presence. I don't know what it is, but what my life needs, give it to me now as a covering. I ask for my own mantle. In Jesus' name, amen. I will read two scriptures. I want you to sit down. One is 1 Corinthians 10. Of course, verses 1 to 4. Put it on the screen very quickly. Once I quote a scripture, put it on the screen so we don't waste time. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 1 to 4. Moreover, brethren, I will not that you should be ignorant how that all our fathers were under the cloud. Now, this evening, I saw God build canopies. Everyone this year was under a covering. Everyone was led from inside that covering this year to protect you from the storms. You know, interestingly, the weather this year changed completely. This haze you are seeing, if you know how many people have become sick all over the world, not just in Nigeria, the trouble is all over the place. The haze is like they send a plague through the haze. And people are just falling sick, fever, everything. My daughter called me from America. She was leaving from work and she was sick. Her son was sick. So a sick mother was going to carry a sick son. I don't know who will nurse the other. And it was a story all over the place. From one part of America or the other, the weather had changed. Here the planes are warned when to fly and when not to fly. It's the same thing in America. It's the same thing all over the world. And I saw God build a covering. He carried people on the, inside that covering throughout this year. Now, I'm taking us to the place of visions now, because that's where I'm concluding tonight. Protected you from the words of men, the arrows of men, wicked men who want to see your downfall won't find it. Those who want to smite you with sickness, it won't catch you. The natural disintegration of the earth, the poison from the earth. These days, you don't even know whether you are eating food or you are eating poison. People are dying from strange diseases. I read in one of the health magazines today. I read many things today. You know, I didn't go anywhere. I was staying under the Lord. So when I stay under the Lord, I see, hear, read too many things. I read a health magazine today that was sent to me on my phone that I subscribed to. And the health magazine was saying that organic foods are no longer organic, organic agriculture. These are the topmost researchers in the U.S. They bring out a magazine every week to talk about specific things, from food to medicine, different kinds of diseases. As you get older, you want to understand. So you don't keep on eating poison. And they said this is the organic, what they call organic. It's no longer organic.
Whatever is used to sustain them destroys them, releases some things through them. And that the worst part is that those things are beginning to bring diseases that science have not discovered their solution. So it means when their disease from that organic thing catches you, there is no cure. Your Panadol and Cafenol and all the other medicines won't stop it. Antibiotics, virus, they won't stop it. Whatever chemical has been mixed that is so mild that has developed another life inside that organic food. It's organic. Because there is less artificiality. It's natural. But it's no longer natural. Somehow along in the processing, something goes in that should not have gone in. So that natural thing reacts to it differently. And you eat it in your body, it grows into something, another spirit in your body. And they found out that that is gradually killing a lot of people. And doctors are not being truthful. They just explain it off. They always have a way of explaining it. Ah! Today, a thief will not steal your life. Because those are little thieves. So people are dying deaths they should not die. Because where they ran to for refuge, that organic thing, that thing that looked safe, became their killer. Who crucified Jesus on the cross? It was those that ate with him on the same plate. Even my friend that I call my friend sold me out. That's the way the Bible puts it. That thing that should be security is now destroyed. Today, I set a canopy between you and all the elements around you. Your life will not be stolen suddenly. Your destiny will not be stolen suddenly. You will live the fullness of your years in Jesus' name. I didn't hear somebody say amen. I will not have you ignorant how that your fathers, our fathers were under the cloud and all passed through the sea. I saw a canopy carrying us. But who did I see in front of that canopy? At the door of that canopy, carrying the canopy. The Messiah himself, the author and the finisher of our faith, the God of our salvation. He built a canopy. Now, look at verse 2. And we're all baptized unto Moses in the cloud and in the sea. Now, go to verse 3. And did all eat the same spiritual meat. Now, let's see how it is defined. Verse 4. And did all drink the same spiritual drink. For they drank of that spiritual rock that did what? Followed them. I saw God from now entering every door with you. He followed you. He built a canopy. His identity went first. You see, when we read that scripture in Psalm earlier, he said righteousness went before. It was righteousness that cleared the way. That is the same thing we are repeating here. He said they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them. And that rock was who? Christ. Now, they spoke about the baptism in Moses. This in the cloud. They spoke about others. But when they defined the covering of Jesus, they connected it to a what? A rock. When my heart is overwhelmed, bring me to that rock.
that is higher than I.
The rock
that is higher than I.
The rock. They drank and ate of different meats. Were covered in the cloud with Moses. So they had the veil of Moses in their eyes into the New Testament. But one of the major covenants outside of Moses that went with them and made them succeed was a rock they met in the wilderness. The rock that shortened the life of Moses. I hope you remember that. He slapped the rock. He said, you don't know I'm a human being, I'm alive. You don't know I'm a living spirit. You slapped me. He said, because of that, you will enter. You are not finishing this race. You don't know I've been with you always. I was the one in that fire that sent you on this journey. I spoke to you in the fire. And you slapped me. He told him before he was slapped that I will go before you and stand before you. I will go before you to that place. So he knew that he was going to find the Father there. And he still slapped him. The rock. But that rock, when they drank of that water, like he said, if you drink of me, you will never thirst again. Some of you have refused to drink. That is why your thirst is always repeating itself. You must ask him to give you of his own living waters so that you can live forever. So that you never thirst again. So that you never get confused again. They drank, and that rock led them through the wilderness. That rock crossed Jordan River for them. That rock helped them conquer the whole land. That rock is the one they are still waiting for today to come back as the Messiah. That rock. I saw that rock create a canopy, and I got disturbed.
Jesus, la 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 la, oh, every day your name is the same. I will long call in your name every day.
Calling your name, calling your name.
the Lord say for the rest of this year? We must run back and hide under the ultimate sacrifice that the world can never defeat. And that is the only magical medicine that can deliver us from all things. Remember the sacrifice. Invoke that sacrifice and do no more. The sacrifice will speak for itself. The sacrifice will defend you. The sacrifice of the only Son of God. The blood of Jesus. He said, invoke it. And every other thing around you will dissolve. Your fears will dissolve. Your cares will dissolve. Your glory will be restored. Today, I don't know how to explain it. When that spirit came upon me this evening or this afternoon, it overwhelmed me on my bed and I just began to cry. Over all the land, until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli! Like some people are already crying now, those who don't know him, who have not gotten ready for this time, who do not understand the times or the seasons of our God, who do not understand that we are in the last days, and in the last days, these things that are happening must happen. If they don't happen, God is not God. As sad as it is, as bad as it is, it's been prophesied. But also God has shown us the way of escape. We chose to follow our ways. That is why we suffer. Even among those who still hear, they still choose after hearing to follow their way. And today I warn you, your way is a pit that will lead you to destruction. Repent and get out of it. And I'll keep warning until my last breath is gone out of me. We are in the last days. And everything God has spoken about the last days is what is being fulfilled. He that has an ear, let him make himself ready. Not let him be warned. Don't get warned and stay where you are. Be ready. Change your ways. So that when that time of refreshing will come, in the midst of the wickedness, he will bring you a refreshing. He will protect you. He will defend you. Blood promised you things. Go back to the cross and hide under that place. I saw that rock leading the people again. I saw that rock. Eli! Eli, lama sabachthani. That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Some of them that stood there, when they heard, thought he was calling Elijah. And straightway, one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on the reed and gave him to drink. Verse 49, the rest said, let be. Let us see whether Elijah will come to save him. And Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. That is the beginning of our resurrection. The moment he died was the moment you got life. And behold, what happened? The veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom. Every mystery that shades you, that stands in your way, was broken that day. That is where we are supposed to go back to. So that which is standing before us might be broken. God said many of us must renew our covenant at the cross again. Many of us, every one of us must go back there. And said, Jesus, where are you beyond the veil?
I have come that I might be sanctified again. I might be smeared again by the blood of Jesus. He says, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom. And the earth did quake, and the rocks rent, and the graves were open, and many bodies of the saints which slept arose, even out of the graves after his resurrection, and went into the holy city, and appeared unto many. Now, note verse 54. Now, when the centurion and they that were with him watching Jesus saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, truly, this was the Son of God. Now, why did they use past tense, was the Son of God? Because when he was alive and in the flesh, they didn't believe that he was the Son of God. By this confession, what they were saying was that this is truly the beginning and the end. This is the God of yesterday that we didn't know or see or understand. The God of today and the God of tomorrow. Now listen. When I read this today, and it was today I was hearing that for the first time, I heard the Lord say, that same day, those centurions received eternal life. They got born again. The Bible says if you will confess that Jesus is the Son of God, you shall be saved. Have you read that in your Bible? I have read that in my Bible. And I had the Lord interpret it to me today. He said that same day they were saved. Even those who were guarding him, those who were supposed to have crucified, they received their salvation that day. That same day. Because if you will confess that Jesus truly from your heart is the Son of God, you shall be saved. And they said, truly, this was the Son of God. And the Lord stopped there. He said, you must allow the Spirit in the blood, the covenant of your redemption, to take over your fight from you now. You must acknowledge him in your place. You must allow him lead the way. At the cross where I first saw the light and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith that I received my sight. He said, we must go back and allow that same light that made the burden to roll away to flash on us again, to visit us again, to restore back our sanity from the insanity that is catching up with us. Some of you are getting so confused that you don't pray anymore. Go back to the cross. You are getting so confused that you are tired of Christianity. Go back to the cross. You are so confused that you are afraid of the future. You are not sure whether you have a future again. The Lord says I should prophesy like John the Baptist. Go back to the cross. Even though all of hell had left their foundations and come after you, they shall fall like the wild wind before you. Amen. And no harm shall come to your dwelling. Amen. But go back to the cross. At the cross, where I first saw the light and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the way. At the cross where I first saw the light
and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day.
God says you must go to the cross and hide behind. If you come against anything, say, where is that my God? Lead the way and I'm following. Not you leading the way, speaking in tongues by faith. No! There is a time you must learn how to hide behind him and let him lead the way. Because he is the way. Because he knows the way. Because he created the way. You were not there when he created the heavens and the earth. He knows the way through that darkness. He knows the source of that darkness. Part of his canopy is darkness. Don't you know that? Go hide behind him and your darkness will disappear. Because he is the way in your darkness. You have never given him the chance to save you. And that is why you are busy wallowing in that potopoto, and there is no salvation. God said the church must go back to the cross. The church must allow the rock lead. Because the rock traveled with them all through the wilderness and brought them to Canaan. The rock! Would carry them to the end of time and hand them over to the Father. After death has been made subject, he will hand over to the Father a kingdom, according to 1 Corinthians 15. A kingdom. He will give the Father a kingdom. That is us. So anybody that does not allow him lead will not be there when he's handing over the kingdom, will not be counted as one of those handed over. Some of you are gra-gra is too much. Go back to the rock and hide. When that curtain was broken, forever it was decreed that every darkness will break as a result of his resurrection. Your life was secured in the breaking of that curtain. Your life was secured in those earthquakes. That anything that comes against you shall face an earthquake, shall face a turbulence, shall face a resistance. Because that blood is yet speaking for you today. In fact, in another version, it was like immediately the blood touched the ground, everywhere scattered. Listen, because this is very important. I saw the canopy of our Christ leading the way in this season and carrying us with him. Because he's the way and he knows the way. Allow him lead the way. I thought I knew the way till last year. Then last year I found out that all my visions were becoming nothing. They didn't show me the exact way. Then, until I began to learn, Lord, help me pick my steps. Show me the way. Everything I try to do can never be more perfect than the one you do. So, can you reset the ministry for me? Recover it. I have lost control. We are no longer in control. Recover it from every strange spirit that has stolen his soul. Lord, I will follow behind because I don't know the way. If you don't save us, nobody will save us. Once I started doing that, in the last 2 years, the Lord began to bring me out of my rocks, and began to place me in his own place, in the palm of his hand. And it is what he reveals to me that I'm allowed to see. What he does not reveal to me protects me. Did you hear what I just said?
what he does not reveal to me is to protect me. He will take care of it so that my fear does not stop me. So I wake up every time and I found out that the danger that will have crushed me, I have crossed it already. I say, hey, how did I get here? I don't know. I said, my son, for the rest of your life, you allow me to lead the way. You will follow. That which you don't understand, don't do. That which you understand that I command you, do. Simple. Is that too hard for you to understand? I said, no, sir. He said, then follow me. He told them, follow me, and I will make you what? Fishers of men. It is follow me, and I will make you. Not you will make yourself. We have stopped following. We are making him to follow us. I repeat, we have stopped following and we are making him to follow us. Let's rise up on our feet tonight. Listen tonight. I don't care whether you heard what I said or you were sleeping while I was speaking. It doesn't matter. If you want him to lead the way, the church has to allow him to lead the way. The protest I had today is that he's not leading. He's not even allowed to lead. And he says, I am the way. I created the way. He made this earth from the beginning. He made all the rivers. I'm not sure he called River Niger from the beginning. He has a secret name that we have not named. By that name, he will control that river for us. So why don't he allow him to take over so that he can call it by the name he called it when he created it, and it will respond? In case you are calling it River Niger and it is not hearing. Because that river existed before Lord Lugard came to Nigeria. And it was not called River Niger, was it? So who told you the name of that river is River Niger? Our villages, their names have been changed several times. I go through this. I hear all kinds of names. And Gwabeki was not called Gwabeki. Go and check. The traditional people had their names. And a land answers by its root name. It lives by its root name. Until you find the definition of its root name, you cannot address the spirit of that land. Because in its root name is its character. Why don't you let the one who knows all the names lead the way? Tauri is a Kashyap. Tauri, stubbornness will kill us. We are so stubborn. Every day you are arguing over nothing. All your knowledge is like filthy rags. It's nothing. PhD people are becoming foolish these days because their knowledge is becoming nothing. They cannot explain the science of the times now. They cannot control it. Every solution they give is adding fire to the situation. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Now listen. You want him to lead the way. You have struggled with too many things. And you are just tired. You are saying, Lord, I'm sorry. Each time I say I'm sorry, I will argue with you. I still argue and I still lead the way. Come, circumcise me of the spirit.
and make me a new creation. Let's start at Calvary again. You want to start at Calvary? I want to leave that seat and come forward here. I'm not asking anybody to raise hand. God has spoken to us severally by his word. Whichever one he used to interpret to your heart, and you need him to lead the way. He said, but we must come back to Calvary. Haven't done everything. We must find our place in Calvary. And you want to come back to Calvary tonight? I want to leave that seat and come. That is the last thing for tonight. Calvary. Calvary. We love the miracles. But until the Lord takes his place in the center of those miracles and the action in our lives, there is no way forward for us. He said, come. Come. I'm not telling you come to me, all you that are heavy laden. I'm saying, come to the way. Come. To give him the right of way. Let him take over again. Let's see where we go. You know, when things get too hot, I hide under him. I say, Lord, I'm sorry if I've taken your place. Take it back from me and lead the way. Break this rock, because you are the rock that cannot be broken. The rock led them through the wilderness. The rock will see us through. That centurion said, truly, this was the Son of God. He has been with us always, and we did not know him, like the Bible says. He was with us throughout, we did not know him. He has had our keys. He has held the keys in his hands. We did not allow him to open the door. In this door this year, except you allow him, your doors will not be open. So you want him to lead? Come here, let's enter into a covenant. Tell him to take back his place and lead the way. Can you just tell the Lord now where you are standing? That you've confessed today that you don't know the way. You want him to take his way, to take over your life afresh and lead you. And carry you through. I don't know how to describe it, but whichever conviction God has given you as you heard this preaching today, pray according to that conviction. Repent for interfering. I'm sorry for my interferences. I'm sorry for my stubbornness. I'm sorry for my argument. All the arguments I've put. I'm sorry for following my way. Whatever you are, is convinces you of. Can you repent of them now? Just tell him I'm sorry. And if it is repentance for sin, repent for sin. You should not be ashamed to them. The prophet said, my sins know me and I know them. We know each other. That was what the prophet said. Tell the Lord today. Let him recover your life from you. From every place of darkness. Let him recover your life. Him receive from you tonight
and give you a new life. Tell him, let the burdens in your life fall away. At the cross, they all fall away. Tell him tonight to restore the original way in your life. Restore the original path. You said, if anybody will come through you, he will find rest. Father, here I come. Make me find rest. You said you are the way. If anybody enters through you, he will find rest. He will find green pastures. Tell him, Lord, open the door. I want to enter through you. And I want you to lead me into my green pastures. Have mercy on me for being stubborn, for leading myself, for arguing with you many times, for ignorance. Forgive me. Take away every condemnation from me. I plead the blood of Jesus to wash me clean. I plead the blood of Jesus to remove the darkness in my life. I plead the blood of Jesus to restore me back to my place of glory, to my throne, to the gift of life, the blessing of life. The blood of Jesus, restore back my covenants. Restore back my covenants. Restore back my covenant. Activate my covenants. The blood of Jesus. This sacrifice today, let it be acceptable. Can you begin to ask the Lord to destroy every altar that has grown during this time of your backslidings? There is no small or big backsliding. Backsliding is backsliding. Tell him to forgive you. Remove the strange altars that have grown to fill those voids. Every strange altar. Some of you, as you are praying this prayer, the root of your problems have been cut off. I can see that in the spirit, and I hear the Lord say, those problems you saw eating you up before you came tonight, tonight you will go back home and you will not find them again, because they have been cut off. They have been cut off. Tell God, every small, any spirit that has taken advantage to fill those spaces, in the name of Jesus, let them be wiped out. That as he restores you, let him restore your habitation. Let him restore your glory. Let him restore back what you have lost and heal your situation. Let him take his place and lead the way. Tonight, tell him you are entering into covenant with him to become that rock that went through the wilderness, that followed Israel through the wilderness. Let him become that rock for you and carry you through the present wilderness. Tell him, Lord, become that rock for me. That rock in 1 Corinthians. Become that rock and break the darkness of this wilderness and go before me from today. I vow to follow you, carrying my cross with me, dying to self. I vow to follow you. Just lead the way, because you are the way, because you create the ways. Lead the way, because you know the way. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Create a covering for me that makes the way for me. That makes the way for me. Create a covering over me that shields me from the wickedness of the seasons. Create the covering of my salvation. Create the covering of my salvation to lead me for the rest of my life. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Christ in me, the hope of glory. I restore your place of glory in my life to carry me for the rest of my life. To carry me for the rest of my life. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Today, I receive my circumcision. I receive the forgiveness of sins, the washing by the blood of Jesus. I receive the cleansing of my life. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Can you shout amen? Can you shout amen? Therefore, tonight, from the foundations of the earth, anything that has taken advantage of the holes that were opened in your life to steal from you or to smite you with sickness and disease, today let that spirit die. Amen. Let that spirit disappear from this congregation. Amen. Let your body be restored now. Amen. I release the blood from Calvary in the name of Jesus to redeem your body now. Amen. To redeem you from that sickness now. Amen. To redeem your soul now. Amen. To redeem your position now. Amen. Receive back your restoration in Jesus' name. Amen. Can somebody wave and shout amen? Therefore tonight, that which was taken, the wounds you were carrying, they are healed now. If you prayed from your heart tonight, your deliverance has come. Can you lift that hand and bless him for that deliverance? Thank you, Jesus, for finding me tonight. Thank you for taking back your place. Can you thank him for taking back his place and for the healing of your body? And I want you to, as you thank him for that, start checking that body. You will find out that the behavior of that body is changing now. Check that hip bone. God is touching that hip bone now. Receive your miracle in the name of Jesus. God is giving you a new womb. A new womb. Because he has taken back his place. All the strange things that took advantage of the vacuums, the holes in your life, I see God push them out. I hear the Lord say, I will follow you home. And I will set everything on fire that has judged you. And they shall judge you no more. Receive your miracle in the name of Jesus. He said, today, I give you a new heart. If you knew you were lost in sin, and today you have returned, tell him, I receive a new heart. And I vow to walk with him for the rest of my life. Therefore, let the blood of Jesus purge out of me now every condemnation from my spirit to my body, to my physical flesh. The blood take away condemnation. Let the spirit of a new life that is in the blood of Jesus take over my physical body and take over my spirit. In the name of Jesus, I receive eternal life through the forgiveness of sins by my repentance today, by inviting Jesus to take back his place in my heart. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for honoring me. In Jesus' name. If you believe God, can you wave and shout amen? If you believe God, can you wave and shout amen? That heaviness over your life is taken away. Every spirit you have been fighting with, every habit you have been fighting with,
Today it is broken in Jesus' name. The cloud that has stopped your moving forward, March shall be a promotion for you. Like the name March means also in English, it will be your movement forward. Everything in your life shall move in this March. I release the spirit of that war to carry you forward. To release you into your Canaan land. In the name of Jesus. By the end of March, everybody here shall have a testimony to give. If you believe that, shout amen. If you believe that, shout amen. If you believe that, shout amen. Can you begin to bless the Lord, somebody? Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Now open your eyes and look at me. He said this month of March, everybody will have a testimony. Yeah. I'm just repeating what he said. So I'm expecting a testimony from every one of you. Yeah. Even if it is one, it will be clear that it is not your hand that did it. Yeah. That it is God. You will bring this testimony in the coming March. Yeah. So coming March, we will open the doors for testimony from this February. Amen. 1 month. Like the word March is, you know, left, right, moving forward. Your life will move forward this month. Amen. I didn't hear somebody say amen. Amen. So for your sake, by the hand of the Lord Jesus, I break the cloud in the month of March. Amen. That cloud will not affect anybody that came for this meeting. Amen. Plus those of you who are sitting and those of you who are outside. I break the cloud in Jesus' name. Your garden shall respond to you. And your miracle shall find you. In the name of Jesus. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody, it's like in the spirit, somebody took a knife and cut your throat. Today, I saw God restore that throat and restored the gifts that were stolen from that throat. Receive back your life in the name of Jesus. There is somebody else here. Everything that helped you before had been cut off. But God says in this match, a new door of help will come to you. Receive your miracle in the name of Jesus. Somebody, two human beings will make a difference in this match in your life. They will be sent by the Lord one after the other. And it will become a turning point for you. Receive your miracle in the name of Jesus. Somebody, I don't know what is wrong with your feet. But God just gave you new feet now. Receive the miracle of that your leg. I say, receive the miracle of that your leg. Receive the miracle of that your leg. Somebody, I see you wearing new shoes. I don't know what that means, but receive your new shoes. I don't know why I keep you. When I come to that song, it is receive my sacrifice of praise. But I don't know the real words, and
you take me to where somewhere your else. Words, can you take it properly now?
I have more than a song today. I brought my sang. I am your sacrifice. I am more than a song today. I brought my sang. I am your worthy. Oh, receive this living sacrifice. I am your worship. Oh, we say, accept this living sacrifice. Yeah, I am your worship. Oh,
while they sang that song, I saw God going around repairing the road through which your blessings come. He was busy repairing. The obstruction in your life is broken. And secondly, I saw God repairing live nerves, the nerves inside your body. It's like there is somebody here or somebody who is watching. I don't know what brought about either a nervous breakdown that makes a tremor take place in part of your body, a tremor, a shaking. It's almost, it's uncontrollable when it happens. It just happens and there is that tremor and something quivers. And I saw the Lord pull out a spirit from your body because of that. And right now, your whole nerves are healed. Your body is restored. That quivering has stopped. Receive your miracle in the name of Jesus. And send the testimony of this wonderful testimony. Somebody shout hallelujah. Ley lines have been broken. And I saw ley lines being reset to serve you positively. Being reset to rechannel merchandise of blessing to your life. Receive the miracle of these new ley lines. Ley lines are the roads that spirits follow, whether in the night or in the day. Every city has them. Every community has them. Kafanchan has them. They call them ley lines. They are spirit lines. I see them being reset not to serve the purpose of Satan, but to serve divine purposes. God is taking back the authority of supply from those that control supply. And is handing over distribution to his church. Those are the things I see tonight. The repairs of the road. Receive your miracle in the name of Jesus. Can you begin to thank God for tonight? Give him glory and praise. I want you to take a sacrifice of praise, an offering of praise in your hands, and we will dance to the Lord, and you will bring it to the altar. We'll just take some 5-10 minutes and just worship, and we close this meeting. Just raise that hand. Taking a deep breath and breathe out. Nache the governor hanum kijano faki nufashi kichiki kipitade shukuma gama faruhu metseriki yada ukeji kinki enzo ze amfane de ke the kai koka de ke the gayao
come de katabaze ze made amfani. Ubangiji ya cire mugunta shetan daga rayuwanka. Wanda ya tsokane ka daga yau zai kone a cikin wuta. Daga yau mulkin rayuwanka ko kuwa rayuwanki ya koma wurin Ubangiji. Yanzu ne amfanin rayuwanki zai fara nunawa. Nagan Ubangiji ya sake haskinki. Ya sake haskinka. Yanzu zaka zama kaman taurarin sama ne. Naga ina maido maka ko kuwa maki mulki da iko, mulki da iko, mulki da iko, mulki da iko. Daga yau zaka zama da amfani, rayuwanki zai zama da amfani. Na gan share wa Ubangiji yana share hanya, yana bude hanya, yana nuna hanya. Daga yau zai ja gaba. Kai ko ke zaki bi kuma ba iko da isa ya tsada tafiyanki daga yau. Can you just bless him? Give him glory. Give him praise. Thank him. Mu gode masa. Mu gode masa. Mu gode masa. Mu gode masa. Kukoma ujen zamanko. You can go back to your seat. Go take your offering. And if you have it, start dropping it. But let's just bless the Lord with thanksgiving today. You want to take a song and let's just bless the Lord together.
Big, big God, mighty God, Jesus Christ is the mighty God. Hallelujah. Mighty God, Jesus Christ is the mighty God. Oh, big, big God, oh, you are mighty God. Jesus Christ is a mighty God. Hallelujah.
Mighty God.
Yeah. Mighty, mighty, mighty God.
Jesus Christ is a mighty God.
Oh, big, big God. You are mighty God. Oh, Jesus Christ is a mighty God. Hallelujah.
Mighty God.
Yeah.
Mighty God.
Oh, oh, Jesus Christ is a mighty God. Oh, you are mighty God. Jesus Christ is a mighty God. Hallelujah. Oh, big, big God. You are big, 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 big. Oh, big, big God. Oh, you are mighty God. Oh, Jesus Christ is a mighty God. Hallelujah. Big, big, big God. You are big, big, big God.
Jesus.
Kauna, kauna itache baba, kauna ala, kauna ya hadamu, aye, 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 aye,
kauna,
kauna, kauna itache baba. Kauna, Allah, Kauna, Taha. Baba, Kauna Allah, Kauna Tahadamu, Aye, 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 Baba, Kauna Tana, Kauna Tana.
From today, everywhere you enter, your legs and your life shall be fruitful. No more stopping you. I say, no more stopping you. Anywhere you enter, while you are yet praying, the answer will overtake you. I see a highway and open door before you. Your life will not carry any weight God has not put in front of you. Receive now in the name of Jesus of the blessings of heaven and the blessings beneath the earth and the blessings upon the earth. They will clothe you and glorify you and defend you. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Can somebody shout hallelujah? You may be seated for a moment. The whole ministry is going through a reset, and I just want to make this announcement. So, don't be disturbed if you hear anything. I'm following things as they come. And this whole quarter, I am in charge of digging the wells of this ministry. And as we dig the wells, we will reappoint people in places, change things without informing them. I don't owe anybody an explanation. But changes are going to continue. It's just movements. Except if you do something that makes you deserve to be moved out of the vision, then we will move you out. Otherwise, you will not be affected. But as we see the changes he's making, because the time we've had him tell Israel to move forward, the time to move forward has come. The time to set the altars all over the place is now. So, if you keep on hearing waves of changes, already they are going on. Our school of prophecy is taking off March 1st. The separate school of prophecy and discipleship training. And please, it will not be called school of prophecy and discipleship. It shall be called school of prophecy and discipleship training. The word training must be added to it. Did you hear what I said? So people don't get carried away prophesying and they forget it's a training. So it's going to be school of prophecy and discipleship training. Practical discipleship will be carried out. Practical prophetic actions and transformations and impactations will take place. And God is saying that the whole ministry must go back to his presence, go back to school. So I am ordering every zonal leaders listed. It's not zone, no. I don't know which letters you were written, but I'm not sure it said zone. Every tower must release two men to come to school of prophecy, either for the 1 year course or the 3 months course. We are going to fix a time that is suitable for those who come for the 3 months course, either during holidays or whatever. And then you come and have an intensive, that one you won't sleep. When I say you won't sleep, you've never been to our schools. Eh? Then you will understand what they look like. You will come find accommodation here or find it in town. And then you will go on through an intensive school of prophecy and discipleship, that same school. The primary qualification of every born-again Christian is a disciple. I am his disciple. Did you hear what I said? If you fail that exam, you won't go to heaven.
the discipleship course. Did you hear what I said? I repeat, if you fail the discipleship course, you won't go to heaven. Then it means you don't exist in Christ. It's supposed to be the easiest. Any Christian that is has not been transformed into a disciple. I'm sorry if I'm going back to the days of deeper life where everything was too strict. You won't go to heaven. It was out of the disciples he chose apostles. He didn't choose them from believers and followers. Hello? Go and search your Bible. I repeat, he didn't choose them from what? Followers or believers, but from disciples. Apostles were chosen. Every worker and laborer in ministry is chosen from disciples. A follower can be non-committal. A disciple is a slave to his master. That's the difference. A follower. A disciple, she ne for konzua church, me she got church, for come waka, for come shara, for come gara kujera. He's a disciple. There's a difference between a disciple and a follower. So if you are a follower, you better make up your mind whether you are crossing over or you are going to be, sit down and look, you know, just be on the fence and be watching. Followers sit on the fence. Believers sit on the fence. You can be a believer and you are not involved in anything. It doesn't matter, you don't believe in Jesus Christ. Disciples don't sit on the fence. Listen to me. In this place, it is your spirit that is trained, not your body. So when you come, our target is your spirit. When your spirit is transformed, your body will be transformed. When your spirit is not transformed, disciplined, your body will not follow. It's your spirit that dictates, that makes you feel you don't want to. Look, let me tell you. Throughout today, my body was in pain. Not from sickness, but from fatigue and tiredness. Every bone here was paining me throughout today. And yet I couldn't sleep. I didn't sleep for 1 hour in the name of siesta from morning till this night. I was just in his presence trying to find something or the other, and the guy was too slow in talking to me. And I had no right to leave until he had spoken. So I was stuck. I thought he would talk to me 1 hour and I sleep 3 hours, come refreshed. He refused till the night time. Only he knows why he does that. But a disciple does not complain. He stays where his master keeps him until he talks. Did you hear what I just said? That is the disciple in me speaking, not the apostle. You must be a disciple first before he can use you for anything. School of discipleship and prophecy is compulsory for all Christians. I was shocked this year, and that was a warning from God. When I was invited to the Baptist conference at the stadium, and what are they talking about? Apostleship and discipleship. Discipleship and apostleship. You must be a disciple. If the Baptist knows this, then the Baptist is about to replace you in heaven. It means the basic church of God is about to overtake every one of you because you are too lackadaisical about it. Discipleship and apostleship. It means the church wants to become the leader. The Baptist church wants to become the leaders of the churches in the world. Because once you get the two right, it's just hallelujah for you. Every branch, and I'm telling you, any area presiding apostle that does not carry this, it shall be removed. It's not that it shall be posted. So that we can cross Jordan. We need the captains that are strong enough to take us through. Not captains who argue with commands. I'm telling you, if we don't see those changes, you are not lasting this year. It's not that we are testing you for years. The change is this year. The movement is this year. So you will forgive me. Get ready for lots of troubles so that we can make heaven. The bones had to, they started cracking. Crack, 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 crack. Bone to bone. Finding their levels. The ones for hand went to hand. The ones for leg. And the sinews. Everything started going until it became a living thing. Ah, may God have mercy on that person whose body those bones were moving. You know why? He went through terrible pains, excruciating pains. Have they ever broken your leg and put it back? Even if they put anesthesia, when the anesthesia dries up, you will go to heaven and come back in pain. You will be baptized by fire. All the painkillers will still save you from the pain. The doctors are here, they will tell you that. How much more when it is all your bones God is cracking? It's a serious matter. Every tower must voluntarily send two people, whether for the short-term course or the long-term course this year, at least. The zone must send two people. The zone must send two people. Because I'm about to finish, you go and sleep on your bed. So you better ask for grace to be awake for another 5 minutes. Otherwise, disgrace, not grace. Disgrace will follow grace. Did you hear what I just said? We must make heaven. Everybody say, I must make heaven. Say, I must make heaven. Do you know what? Somebody even said, somebody cracked a joke somewhere. He said, not a joke. It wasn't a joke. He was serious. He said, not even God is strong enough to stop him from making heaven. You know what he meant by that? God has set the rules for heaven. If you believe, you will make heaven. He believes. And he has told God, even if he's not qualified, qualify me. He's the qualifier. Did you hear what I just said? That one will make heaven. He said, God, any sacrifice you want me to make, I will make. I must make heaven. I'm not going to be like that stupid rich man who was just told to go and sell all his property. I followed him. He said, what? I don't have existence anymore if I sell all my property. Then I'll become like any ordinary man. Yes, until you become like an ordinary man, God cannot lead you. Did you hear what I just said? Say, I must make heaven. Otherwise, this our work is in vain. All this pastoral work is in vain. I don't want people who will not make heaven. I want to be in heaven with a crowd. And together we are singing and dancing together. Can somebody say amen to that? So send you that you are hearing me here, whether you belong to a tower or not. March 1st. Is the beginning of the one year course. There is a holiday in between. March 1st is going to be a wonderful season. Then those who are coming for the intensive 3 months course, it is from those who have attended those courses who will choose leaders in the future. In another 2 years, only those who have attended those courses, whether they failed or passed, at least they mark present in the courses. They have an idea of what it looks like to be a disciple. Only they can lead other people. Not people you call for prayer meeting. They say, sir, I'm busy, I'll come later. Tassie is here. He comes from Port Harcourt every month. Now, it's almost predictable that he must be here. I was talking to a government official, another government official, top one. And he said, Mrs. Shaba, he named three people he knew, elders who were older than him. Every month, a pastor in Jos named up to five people he knows, and a governor, I think it was even the governor himself, named three people. There is no month. They may not even be attending the meetings in Jos, but they are here every month. There are those from Abuja who don't attend the meetings, but they are here today. Discipleship. A disciple to Christ will be his slave that follows him everywhere according to his leading. You will not be a leader again if you have not gone through the discipleship. In your local churches, you go through baptismal classes, don't you? And almost everybody here has gone through a baptismal class before getting baptized, and you have a certificate. And the baptismal class, is it for 1 week? No! You've gone through beginner's classes. Why is it that you can't go through discipleship class? If you are truly born again. The true room does not have baptismal class. It does a shortcut baptismal class and baptizes people who get born again. But the throne room has discipleship class and prophetic classes so you can survive your life. That is our baptismal class. We want to give you a certificate for heaven. So it's going to be compulsory this year. March 1, if you have the space, you are not doing too much, come to the school. If you are a graduate, you are not doing too much, come to the school. Asuku, I know you are smiling because I will call your name. Aki, Sam, who is the fourth person now? Austin. Every zone must sponsor nothing less than 3 people to that school. 3. That means apart from the 2 that goes from a tower, you can take 1 and also sponsor. We have not given the fees yet. We are going to decide that in the coming week when the provost reports. We have decided to appoint a brand new provost from outside the mainstream of the ministry here, from one of our branches. Somebody who we are appointing to become a yoke master, and carry you through the drills. He's a drill master, spiritual drill. How many of you really went to our school when it first started? When Gaya was provost? Raise your hand if you went to school when Gaya was our school of prophecy. I can say, you see now, it means we have backslidden because it means we have not really carried the real students yet. That was the time when we had the real school of prophecy and discipleship. Most of our senior staff went through that school. The older staff. Now, we are reopening that school with the same vigor that we had, if not a higher one. And we are bringing somebody who knows no other person but Christ. So you better convince him with Christ. Otherwise, you won't escape him. As the village headmaster and provost of that school. Did you hear what I just said? Because we realize that people who didn't go through that school are fast becoming leaders and growing in the branches. And we are afraid that they are trying to pull us one way and we are trying to go another way. Because they didn't go through the school. They don't understand the way of Scripture and the way of the prophet or the way of the disciple. And they didn't go through those kind of trainings in their churches either. So there is a problem. And the ministry is growing bigger and bigger. And it keeps on growing. So we have to now start training. So this year, we are going to be involved in a lot of training. This year. In order to get the ministry upgraded properly for the work and the vision that is ahead. So our darkness does not overwhelm us. I've spoken about, you may be seated, please. So go and start gathering money. Kaduna, sorry, please. I didn't call you, Musa. I didn't call you. It's because you are the latest coordinator and it's easier to forget the new wine. It's the old wines that have oppressed me too much and fellowship with me every day that I remember. You are just joining, so I will learn to remember you too. My office is taking charge. So administration now is from my office. I'm going to appoint coordinators under my office who answer to me directly. Everything is cross-checked by me. Did you hear what I just said? Because I'm the only one that can force that change. If I bring an administrator, you will argue with him. Argue with me and see whether anybody will answer you. When you hear an answer, it will be coming from heaven. So it's for your good, you don't argue. It means that is the letter from heaven. That is the spirit from heaven saying, this is the way, follow ye therein. There is no argument. And since my office took over 3 weeks ago, if you know the changes that have taken place, only the heavens will speak. One of it is the school. The other one is the youths. We are moving them from the women department and the children department and the youth department. The seraphims are now coming under my office directly. So I can fast track them. I can give them deadlines. If I tell you in 3 months' time, birth, 3 months you must give birth. I can raise apostles out of all of them. Mentor them so that when I die, there will be strong fires all over the place, burning the earth and moving with the revival. The season is a season of war, and I want to raise men that can withstand the battle and fight it. So I'm bringing them under me. That way, they will meet the goals of heaven for their lives. They won't give reasons why they failed. That way, none of them will fail. Everybody I mentored or watched over, kept an eye on, became great. So we are going to change the tide. Please, every young man and woman here, join the seraphims. Become a burning angel, a burning fire. Did you hear what I just said? Join the seraphims. I hope you also know that seraphims are worshippers. So I'm expecting you to raise a worship team that will beat this one's hands down. Different from this team. You can have members here, but bring your own choir or singing group. When they open their voice, everybody will stand up and join. Did you hear what I just said? Start the revolution here. So I'm giving you 3 months. You see, the 3 months command from my office has begun. To raise seraphims of songs. Because they are first worshippers. And let's see what happens. Did you hear what I said? Listen. Next month, March, end of March, like I said, you must bring your testimonies. Testimonies. Listen. The winds of the Spirit. I don't know, Kim, who told you that it includes all zonal pastors. Who told you that? Nobody. Those days are over. I'm dissolving the former committee that did the winds of the Spirit. Because this month, they started preparation 3 days to the time or 4 days. And that is an abomination in this ministry. I have prayed and I have orders to step them down. So I'm dissolving them. And I'm raising a committee of 5 captains. I don't even know who they are yet. 5. Not all zonal leaders. Zonal leaders. We must not put you in a committee for you to come for prayer here. Did you hear what I just said? It's your business to mobilize the bosses. And some of you came with bosses today. And we give God glory. Can we put our hands together for the zonal leaders? Some of you came with buses today, which will carry you out this morning back to your destination, and the Lord will take you safely. But no zonal, I saw Kim write all this list here. I don't know who gave him that list, but I'm not the one. He's trying to help me. He's the administrator in my office. No zonal leader will be part of that committee. I don't need 20 men in a committee. That's why the work is not done. Everybody is thinking the other person is doing it because they are 20. 5 will control 1,000. These 5 men, when they give you orders, you better obey. I'm going to raise 5 people, and the nations will be gathered. The International Conference Committee can do with 20. It's a bigger meeting.
It has this larger group. You will still belong there, but not winds of the spirit. We don't need 20 people, all heads of department. No, I'm dropping them. Because all heads of department were there, and the winds of the spirit almost became empty. So we didn't know who they were inviting, themselves and the Holy Spirit. We are changing that. 5 people will be that committee. They will pray and fast together, organize the whole thing together. And they will start early enough. Early enough. The Lord will help us. All towers must carry out elections this year, except the towers whose committees are not up to 3-4 years old. But if you have completed 4 years, what are you waiting for? You are waiting for command from headquarters. This year is a change of oil. Go back and be reaffirmed. The same committee can be returned by the tower, so that's okay. But be reaffirmed. Otherwise, go back to the Holy Spirit. Choose leaders whose spirits are boiling. Captains who can break down the Philistines and keep the army on. Captains who can sing songs of praise like angels. Captains who can pray for married people and counsel them. Not captains whose marriages are also suffering. Did you hear what I just said? All those backsliding traits of the church must not be found here. So, if you know that you don't qualify, step down. We will honor that. Look, if at the end of the election you have only 3 people to lead, let them lead as long as they qualify. The Spirit of God will multiply in them. Things will change overnight. Did you hear what I just said? Lastly, we are looking for workers who can do 3 things at once, even if they are in administration. They can pray, they can evangelize, that means they can preach, even if they are not evangelists. They can preach, they can exhort, they can edify. They know their scripture very well. And then, lastly, they can train or disciple somebody else in anything. That means they can become counselors. But if you cannot do any of the 3, any, don't apply. Did you hear what I said? And all those who are interviewing must look out for these 3 things. Not by questions, by real test. Prof, can I jiku? All those who are interviewing, because Prof is the head of those interviews. All those interviewing must look for these 3 things when you are interviewing any staff. You must be able to handle the word. That means preach the word, exalt, train or counsel, evangelize, and pray. This is a prayer ministry. If you cannot pray, don't join us. So if you meet somebody in the administration, he can cast out your demons, heal your sick, give you counsel. You meet a full-time pastor, he can cast your demons, heal your sick. That is the basic qualification. That was the basic qualification in the Acts of Apostles. We are going back to those qualifications again. Because it's like people who cannot even do "For God so loved the world" are becoming senior staff. And they cannot do "For God so loved the world that he gave you a little begotten son." They start saying, "I know it, sir." And they start giving you the shortcut of it. There is no shortcut to heaven. You either qualify, you don't qualify. How do you raise disciples when you don't know the word? So this year, the ministry is changing. By the end of the year, you will enter here. You will know the difference. Nobody needs to talk to you. Did you hear what I said? How many of you say amen to these changes? Amen. My Father, I thank you. Today, I say, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in our lives and on earth. But first in our lives, as it is in heaven, we receive the blessing of this day with thanksgiving. And we receive the harvest of the month of March. We give you glory for every testimony tonight and the testimonies that will come.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, we pray. Now, the Spirit of the Lord go with you and prosper you and make you prosperous. In Jesus' name. I want to welcome again all of you who came tonight, and especially our chief host here in the state. The Lord bless you and remember all of you. Shalom. The peace of the Lord go.
Heaven and earth adore you. Angels bow before you.